everybody. Welcome to Club Rugby TV. It's Wednesday night. It's 9 o'clock, and it is, of course, your favorite Club Rugby show. Nice to have you. I've got some special guests on the show, and tonight we're celebrating the life and times of Tinus Lanier. It was his funeral, sadly, on a Saturday, and we want to remember Tinus. A number of people contacted us on social media and said, why don't we do a full show on Tinus? And Jerome Paarwater, one of my guests this evening, as you have seen on the show before, made the suggestion last week that we bring some of his close friends onto the show. Of course, we're also now going to touch a little bit on the West Bromwich Club Rugby Sevens that played out at City Park over the weekend. But we'll get into that a little bit later. So, folks, tonight is a slightly different show. We'll talk a little bit of Sevens. We'll talk a little bit about Tinus. We'll talk a bit of Sevens. And we'll talk about Tinus. But we've got a great panel with me on the show this evening, all friends of Tinus Lanier. And starting on the far right, no stranger to Cape Rugby TV, Jerome Paarwater. Jerome, hoe gaan we jou vanavond, meneer?
JP, het gaan een beetje beter. Verlede week was een tough week geweest. Ons is al verlede week jou amper elke aand bezig geweest met verschillende diensten voor Tinus. En ja, tot zaterdag toe was allemaal maar redelijk bezig geweest. So, ja, so, openlijk is die week een beetje rustiger.
Ja. Een van ons ander gaste vanavond, mensen, Dolfie te Veer. Het ek het recht gesê, Dolfie?
De Veer.
En ek gaan jou maar net voorstel as goeie vriend van Tinus.
Ja, dat is maar al. Soos Jerome gesê, dit was hartseer vir ons, vir Tinus, laas week neer te gaan leen, maar ons gaan voort. Nee.
Maar welkom en ek bly vir julle hier te heen. En of course, another friend of Tinus, ook Afrikaanse man, lekker praat soos de boerentaal, ne? Russel, Roux. Hallo Russel.
Hallo.
Lekker om jou hier te heen. Jy het ook saam met Tinus gespeeld, ne?
Baie dankie, yes. Ek het gespeeld saam om, VIP. Ek het VIP klaar gemaakt toe hy aan die spanne kom het.
Oké, maar so jy is een klein beetje ouder zijn?
Yes.
Alright. Ek wou nou nie gesê die, maar Jerome het so gesê aan die ene kant. Ek gesê, moet nie Russel sy ouderdom noem nie. Toe sê ek, maar hy lyk so nog so 34, kan seker een comeback maak.
Nee, ek raak nog 50.
Oké. Sien as jy dan nou kat in die sak en jou los, dan laat ek jou maar so maak, ja. Oké, Jerome, let's talk quickly about, well, the last time was, of course, last week, Wednesday night, and since then there were a couple of memorials. People have been talking about Tinus across the country, across the world, in fact, about Tinus. I suppose, we talk about death, but one has to go through this process of meeting the people, shaking the hands, visiting the family, doing the memorials, and finally putting him to rest.
Yeah, JP, it was quite tough, and it was quite a long week last week. Starting Monday, last Monday, I went with some of the Western Province executive guys. We went through to Tinus's house just to be there with his wife and with his family. And then on Wednesday, we had another memorial service at Norden's Avenue, at Avenue Park, where there was a couple of friends and or a lot of guys who played with Tinus for Avenue Norden's at that time were there. And so everybody, a lot of guys, they say sort of their tributes, playing with Tinus. And Gerald Scholes was talking good, and Charlton April was talking about Tinus.
I'm one of the legends who spiel to ons gespeel het by the game. Wie was VIP legends? Yeah, yeah, legends, Tinny Northern's legends, ne?
Yeah, yeah.
Het jy gespeel, Russel?
Yeah, daar.
Just like, het jy gesurvive? Want ek sê jy daar
20 minute.
20 minute. Ek was die cameraman op die dag, want ek het nie as hy 20 minute survive nie. All right, so it's been a process of grief and obviously a little bit sadness. How's his wife Anna and the family doing?
I've spoken to her over the phone this afternoon. She seems fine. She's a tough lady, and she really she's an amazing lady. For what she's done for Tinus, and I mean, she stood by him in good times and in bad times. In the last few days were really not so good times, but she stood by him and she gave everything for Tinus, and it was really, she's a really amazing lady.
Was there any indication, Adolfi, was there any indication, you know, just before Tinus passed, Because obviously the last time since he was diagnosed, he wasn't in good shape, and it got slowly degressed his health. But was there any indication that in those last few days that it was chronic?
I would say so. Me and Russell visited Tinus that Saturday, just, and he died on the Monday, and he was fine. He was still the same Tinus, smiling, holding his hand out, you know, as always.
Yeah.
But we didn't foresee that this is going to happen now, but we knew Tinus was sick, so we didn't prepare.
Because, I mean, this MND, this motor neuron disease, we don't really know much about this, Russell.
Yeah, what if?
So jylle, toe jylle daar so Saterdag was, jylle, was so gesellig soos
die... Gesellig toe voorin, ja. En maandag ook en toe sat ek aan die voorkamer en kyk nog TV. Toe kom die meisie kind by die kamer uit gehardloop. En ek vraag haar, wat is dit nou? Sy kan nie praat hier. En sy heel net, vraag haar my, meisie kind, wat is dit? Toe sê sy. En die tyd in.
Die tyd het nou gekom. Ene,
En die ene nog op jou.
Ja, nou. So, Russel, vertel ons bietjie van waar jy eerste vir Tinus ontmoet?
Ek het met Tinus ontmoet toe ons by WP was.
Ja.
Ek was besig om klaar te maak eindelijk. My rugby loopbaan is toe hy ingekom in Chester.
Okay, nou, so, wacht, voordat ons oor Chester praat, vertel ons gauw bietjie jou rugby loopbaan. Jy het vir WP gespeeld.
Ek het WP Liga, ek het by Perl Liga begin.
Ja, ja.
Toe is ek WP Liga. En toen ik Perl die gaf, ja, VP. En toen ik bij je aan de provincies spannen behaal, zoals die Barbarian-span.
Ja.
Dat was de tijd wat ik in de weekse tijd 3 games ga spelen, die maandag, die woensdag en die zaterdag.
Joh, ik denk die bokken kan ook hij doen niet. Misschien, alhoewel, het misschien deze is het nodig om te doen.
Ja. Je weet het.
En in positie, ik neem
ik achter... Ik center gespeeld.
Center?
Ik heb heel achter gespeeld. Ik
is al groot voor de center.
Ik begin bij fly-off.
So jij en Tinus het zeker een beetje okay, so hij het soort van onder jouw skade weer ingeskuif.
Dat is erg, ja.
Groot skoene om vol te maken.
Ja.
En Dolfie, jij het samen met Tinus groot geworden?
Ja, ik en Tinus is samen groot geworden. Ik heb gewoond in Perl Oos, in Klein-Edeburg. En die woonstellen wat ons gebleven is net achter die schoolse sportveld. En Tinus en sy groep sou altyd daar kom oefen. En ek sou maar daar sit en die onderwyser het gesien, maar ek het nie daar...
Hoe oud was julle toe?
6, 7.
6, 7 jaar oud?
Ja.
En wat meen jy sy groep? Was dit nou die ander...
Die kinders wat samen om in die school was, in Chester, en Chester se broer Wilmot was ook in die groep. En die onderwyser het my gesien daar sit en dan het hy my saamgenooi. En van toe af het ek elke middag saam met hulle geoefen.
So jy het saam rugby gespeel vanuit jy nou 6 jaar oud is. En so dit was nou wat, nou op die laerskool?
Op die laerskool, ja. Hoërskool is ek in Tinus in een school gewees. Paulus Joubert, senior secondaire school.
Ja.
Waar het ons nou saam rugby gespeeld.
Op die Perl, hè?
Voor die school en voor die dorp,
ja. Ja, ja, ja. En jouw positie, wat jy gespeel?
Ek het tussen vleel, heel achter en loskakel geboer.
Geboer, en die dorp moet jy natuurlijk boer. En het jy altyd, het hy altyd center gespeel? Waar, toe hy kleintje was, wat hy water gespeel?
Tinus is een baie frisser as ons, toe ons groot geworden.
Ja.
En hy het stit gespeel vir ons.
Stit?
Hy was onder 13 kaptein van die WP Liga, stit.
Jerome, vertel ons gauw bietjie vir die mense wat nou nie, en ek is een van die mense wat aan die kant van die fans natuurlijk groot geword het. Verduidelik vir ons gauw weer die verskil tussen Liga, Federation en SARU, as jy nou voor Unification kyk. Verduidelik vir ons, want dat is natuurlijk die boorde en so wat daar was. City & Suburban en die Somerset boorde en die Tigerberg boorde en so. Verduidelik gauw.
Ja, daar was een split in die rugby, JP, destijds nog in die apartheid jare, dat sekere mense het gekies om nie in gemengde sport deel te neem mee, en sekere mense het gekies om gemengde sport deel te neem, en ons het gekies om in gemengde sport deel te neem.
Wat is een gemengde sport?
Saam met die wit mense.
Oké, die wit mense in die ene kant, saam met die swart mense en die kleerling mense. Oké, gemengde sport.
En wie allemaal wil speel.
Waar kom die vraag vandaan? Wie te gemengde sport? Ek moet nog, die gemengde sport.
Dit is my nou amper soos een mengelmoes.
Een mengelmoes, want as ek sê gemengde sport, dan denk ek, dis cricket en rugby en sokker saam.
Ja, dit was net rugby. Ja, maar ons het, ons wit, zwart, bruin, het saam gespeel. En dan was daar
En daar is wat?
Brein, ja. D-
wat was daar nou? Wat?
Dat was die federasie.
Okay.
En dan was het, destijds was het die ander manne, die Saru manne, wat zwart en brein, wat gekies het om nie saam in die wittes te speel.
Okay, so die Saru was non-whites?
Ja, non-whites. All the non-whites played in that era, in the apartheid years. And yeah, and that was sort of the split in the rugby.
Were there any white guys that tried to squeeze into that team ever?
Into which team?
Into the Saru teams.
No. Yeah, Chicky Watson.
Chicky Watson,
yeah, Watson played in that team. And I think there was another couple of guys who played there who didn't agree with apartheid, who played in that side.
Yeah.
So yeah.
But I mean, their life must have been in danger a few times. Russell, jy ken seker 'n paar van die ouens, né?
Ja.
Gevaarlik om as jy witman was in die Saru daar te speel.
Ja, kan dan het nog van Rob Lou. Toe het man net 'n game gehad kyk. En toe wil die mense van hom.
Dit was gevaarlig genoeg net om te kyk.
Kyk, ja.
Ja, ek kan dink. Okay, so you had Federation, you had Saru, and how does the Liga?
Then obviously there was Western Province, the Western Province that's now, and then we were the Western Province League team, which was like we had whites, blacks, and everybody in the team. But you could also play because Russell played Western Province League, and he played Western Province. So I played Western Province League and Western Province. So
the Western Province League came from which section? From Federation or
Federation?
From Federation. Okay.
So but we were basically at one stage sort of a feeder team for Western Province. And I remember, I think it was 1990, where we would have the Western Province League would have more supporters because we played all in Tal Yusufat. Or at Forest Street,
yeah,
where we would have more supporters than the Western Province team at Newlands. I promise you, JP, because of the type of rugby that we played.
Yeah. But isn't that still the case today? I mean, look at what we've got in club rugby.
It's definitely.
We go down to Solarians, or we go down to St. George's, or we go down to Violets. If I just think about some of the bigger ones, Hands and Hearts.
Yeah.
Hands and Hearts plays Kraaifontein, and we've got 5,000 Oaks around the field. We've been to some really, really big club games.
Yeah, look, if you go to Tigerberg in Belhar or whatever,
yeah,
derbies and things like that, you get close to 6,000 people in the game and things like that.
Tigerberg, bro, yeah, there's a big one.
But that time, JP, that time when we played for the Western Province League team, we would have 25,000-30,000 people. Then it would be 5,000 people at Newlands, I promise you.
Unbelievable.
It was amazing.
But of course, back in those days, I mean, rugby, it was like come Saturday, it was an occasion.
Saturday, yes.
So yeah, it was like going to the movies. Yes. Russell?
Yeah. For all the league gespeeld het. Op die dal, Talosa wat stay doen. Of op Forest stay doen. Dan maak die mense van Vrydag af al reg al, van Saterdag se game. En as die spelers daar geland het, dan het daar altyd lyne gestaan van die hek af tot by die stadium. Net om vir ons te kry daar so.
Is dit nou vir die spelers om amper soos deur die tonnel te loop?
Ja.
Right, folks, we're going to be carrying on like this for quite a while still tonight, so make sure you don't go anywhere because I think the Tinnis Lanier stories are going to start coming out like you won't believe. We're going to take an ad break. Remember, we've still got the Sevens highlights. Of course, the West Bromwich Club Rugby semis and finals were held at City Park over the weekend. We'll be taking a look at that and continuing talking about the life and times of Tinnis Lanier, South African rugby legend. We'll continue with that after the break. Stay tuned. Welcome back, everybody. It's Cape Rugby TV. Remember, you can find us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/CapeRugbyTV, or on Twitter, @CapeRugbyTV. Or if you want to follow me with my thousands and thousands of Twitter followers, it's @JPNordia. Alternatively, if you want to follow somebody with zero Twitter followers, you can follow Jerome 6. Nee, Jerome?
Definitely. 6 or 8.
Hoekom het jy geregister? Ek verstaan nie, jy het geregister op Twitter, jy los dit net daarso. Jy gooi hom lekker hierso op die screen, Jerome 6 vir Twitter, allemaal tweet vir jou, maar jy... Do you ever look at your Twitter, because it's gonna...
No, JP, I don't like Twitter and I don't like Facebook.
But you registered?
Yeah,
All right, folks. For those of you that don't know, we've actually got a broadcast legend in our space. You know, we don't often get guys from the world of broadcast, international broadcast, here with us, and a man who puts global rugby broadcast together, Dolfie the Veer. Nah, Dolfie, as it come now, right?
You come now,
all right, I'm almost there. Listen, so we've got to talk to you more about tennis, but just to give the folks a little bit of a background, and I'm going to come back to your school day times. Quickly give us a rundown. I mean, I thought it was fascinating what you were telling us. You work for a company called Proactive, and you guys do global broadcasting for the IRB?
Yes, we involved in global broadcast of live sevens all over the world for the IRB.
Yeah.
That's the HSBC Sevens World Series, and also the Sevens World Series for women.
That must take a lot of work, huh?
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but I enjoyed it. And I'm, well, for me, it's just to be part of rugby is one of the things that we dream of, you know.
And Sevens rugby, I mean, this sort of in the last 10 years has really taken off.
Yes, definitely. If you look at tournaments like Dubai, Hong Kong,
Vegas,
Twickenham, Wellington, those are the biggest tournaments that you can have, and it's a business, you know. That's run like a business.
Yeah.
I'm talking about Twickenham, 100,000 people a day.
Wow.
It's amazing just to see all those people.
I mean,
New Zealand, the same. And also, I mean, Hong Kong, it's sold out already. There's no more tickets.
Unbelievable. It's been going for a long time now.
Exactly. So.
But do you, I mean, I know that you guys there, now that you grew up in the PAR, but obviously you've moved on to bigger things. And you know, we're very privileged to have you here, because we don't often get big shots like you on, you know. And I mean, we hope and pray, those little people like us down here, that you guys who move into the big world, that you don't forget about us. But are you aware of what's happening in Western Province Club Rugby with the Sevens, and how active it is and how well it's doing in the communities?
Well, the first time I was watching, you know, because I'm busy in rugby a lot,
yeah,
and don't watch a lot of rugby,
yes,
a club rugby actually, and then I saw the Western Province team doing really good in the World Club Rugby in Twickenham, so that was quite amazing seeing those guys playing there, and I was so proud of them
playing there. Okay, well then we've got a little bit of a treat for you, because it was our Western Province Club Rugby Sevens. The finals was last week, and let's quickly look at some of the pools there, folks. In the pools, of course, in Pool A it was Durbel UWC, Silver Leaf Hands and Hearts. In Pool B was Marty's Belleville, Strand and Macassar, and then Kales River, Vicks Gardens and Temps in Pool C. And then, of course, False Bay, Tigerberg, Youngstars and Cryfontein were in Pool D. Let's catch up with quickly some of the highlights from the Shield final. This was Strand up against Tigerberg. Let's see what happened. Right, so of course that was Strand Rugby Football Club against Tigerberg there. I think we're going to see some interesting public relations coming from Strand Rugby during the next year. I'm going to tell you guys more about that in the shows still leading up to the end of the year. But look out for Strand. I think we're going to see some interesting moves there. I'm looking for Tigerberg to bounce back, though, considering that their season didn't go so well in Super League A this year. But look out for Tigerberg next year. You know, they say that there's nothing worse than a hungry lion. Don't mean the hungry lion. But you guys know what I mean. All right, let's catch up with the highlights. Marty's against False Bay. These are two teams. They really gave each other horns. Let's see what happened. Yeah, so good one there from Marty's against Tigerberg, and of course Marty's going. How did they do against? Let me just quickly try and catch up there. Was that Marty's against Tigerberg? Because I see Marty's did lose against Kales River in the plate. So Marty's there, of course, against False Bay. Sorry, not against Tigerberg, but Marty's beating False Bay 26-12. So good result for them there. And then of course in the cup final. Now watch carefully for the very last second of the game, the dying seconds. Some interesting footage there. UWC up against Kales River. Let's see what happened there. Okay, so it was a good result there for UWC beating Kells River, 22 points to 21. Let's quickly look at some of the results then of the teams that did play at City Park last week. Wednesday was it? No, Thursday. Let's quickly look at those results. And of course, Gardens went down to Strand. That was in the playoffs. Tigerberg 40-0 over Durbel. There's an incredible result. We've had some real turnarounds here. UWC beating False Bay 17-12. Marty's going down to Kells River then, 29-24 in the cup on the plate. And then the bowl final, Durbel once again bouncing back a little bit, 20-0 over CPUT Gardens. And then Strand beating Tigerberg, as you saw in the highlights, 19-7. And then False Bay going down to Marty's. And the cup final, UWC winning for the second week in a row and beating Kells River. Two good sides there. Jerome, you still happy with the quality of our sevens?
Yeah, definitely.
And I keep asking you this every week.
No, but definitely it was good. And there was some good competition. And the reason why you see that big score of Durbel is Durbel went, the guys left Friday for, they went to play.
Oh, to Nico?
No, in Upington.
In Upington.
Yeah, and they actually beat Upington 82-29.
Yeah, I saw something in the 20th minute, they were 40-0 up already.
Yeah, so that's why that score of the sevens guys.
Let's just go back a step here. So Durbel went to go play in Upington. Was this one of the qualifiers
that
for the Community Cup?
It was one of the still for the qualifiers.
Okay,
but I think they definitely qualified now.
Yeah, I think now they're definitely qualified. All right. Okay, we managed to catch up with Ruan Mostert. He's, of course, the captain of the Western Province Rugby 7 side. This is now the Provincial 7 side. And he talks about Durbel winning the bowl final. Of course, Durbel preparing for next season as well. Let's catch up now with Ruan Mostert.
The guys are really pushing for that position, and it was a bit tough on us with the sevens because a lot of the guys got pulled up to the first team and a lot of injuries. I mean, it was a long season, so the guys struggled a bit, but Durbel will always try and pull something off, so we'll have to wait and see on Saturday. Well, it all depends on what happens on Saturday, so if we qualify for the Community Cup, then I guess it's the Community Cup, and then just going full steam for the sevens again. I mean, it's a game we love, so we have to play it. Yeah, well, came as a bit of a surprise with the bowl final. I think our preparations was a bit harsh, but I mean, like I said, we're one big family at Durban, and we try to pull it through, and luckily we won the bowl final.
Yeah, Ruan Mostert there, very positive, got a great future ahead of himself, and I think we're still going to see a lot from that young man. He seems to have recovered now from his injury that he picked up on his international tour. We'll take an ad break, and when we come back, we'll catch up with Dolfie de Veer and Jerome Paarwater, and of course Russel Roux, telling us more about Tennis Linea. We've still got two more interviews coming up as well. We'll be talking to Dale van Skalkwyk about winning the two tournaments within the week, as well as their preparation for the USA tournament, and the coach of UWC, Clement Trout. We'll be back with you in a sec. Welcome back, everybody. Yes, Cape Rugby TV. All right, we are talking about and celebrating. We're not just talking, we're celebrating the life and times of Tennis Linea. And we're not going to do it in a sad way. We are, of course, very sad, but we're not going to do it in a sad way. We're going to smile, and we're going to talk about the good life and times of tennis. Dolfie, I'm going to come back to you now. You had gespeeld some with tennis, you were 6 years old, and then where did you go after that then? After primary school?
Yes,
he was in Nederburg primary school,
yeah.
And you were in another school?
Yes, I went in William Lloyd primary school, and after primary school, went to high school together.
Yeah.
Started at grade, was it 7?
Yeah.
In high school.
Standard six
around there.
I can't still work out this grade.
I don't know, me too. So, and from there on, we played in the same team, luckily.
Yeah.
You know, I know a few stories of tennis, playing rugby there.
What position was he playing then in high school?
From then on, tennis moved up to center.
Okay.
And that's where he was the most devastating tackler that I ever saw on a rugby pitch.
Even at the high school?
At high school. There was once that we played in a school game at Dal Yosefot Stadium against New Orleans Senior Secondary School.
Yeah.
And this one winger came in the same channel that Tinas was defending. and he's a really good mate of us. And he woke up the next day in hospital.
Come on, who's this guy? tell us.
Andre Windvogel.
Andre Windvogel.
He's a prison warder in Paul, very good friend of us. But I mean, unfortunately, he was in Tina's channel and he was taken out.
Really? So even at school level, he was putting in hard hits.
He was really tackling.
Russel, but it seems like that was his thing. Do you remember the same kind of stories?
He was a Terminator. Hy was toe ons by VP gespeel het, ek klak wel toe. Ons altyd geoefen na seisoen. Het hulle ons afvaard daar na UCT toe. Die pul daar so. As ons hier vandaan hebben die perl gered, ek en hy in Chester. Dan moest ons gaan oefen. 2 uur moest ons daar wees. Dat is lekker gepraat in die kar, van die Chesterse kar.
Ja.
Ga oefen daar so. As ek haak gelag geoefen, ons kom huis toe. Kan die man praat he, a praat die man met mekaar he.
Amo stakken.
Zo moog was ons gewees. En Tienes, kan Tienes, as hy gespeel het, klaar gespeel het, altijd Sadra, of as hy zonde, as hy weggespeel het in die Blauwbulle of Vrijstaat of zo, dan kom terug in zondag, dan bel hy me altijd, en sê my Maaike, ek is op pad door Rasta, het my gesê Rasta. En ek het vir hom gekool, takatak.
Nou, hoekom, sê gauw vir ons, hoekom die Rasta, ek wil net weet, hoe was hy hierstel?
Ja, Rasta, nee, ek het twee.
Het jy nie dreadlocks?
Nee, die dreadlocks.
Nou, het is just, het lees met Russel en Rasta, you know, it's easier for us on the tongue.
Rasta, of course, ja, Rasmus actually was also used to.
Ja, they call him Rasta too.
Rasta, ja. Nou, hoekom tikketik?
Tikketik.
Waar kom daar vandaan?
Ons het een hand, ons het gekeier, toe dus bier gedrink.
Ja.
Toe het hy die bier te vinde geslik. En toe is het tak. En vanuit die taf, toe is die tak.
Dit is als naak so, hoe een man een bijnaam kan optel, hy is over net so, ja.
Nee, dat het vir my gebel altijd, sê, my wat maak ek vandaan? Dan sê ek, nee, ek sit my hier so, kyk hier rugby. Vraag hy, joh, right, hy gaat oorkom. Nou, dan bel hy vir sy vrou nou, Inna.
Ja.
Die Inna nou, vraag hy nou vir haar, hoor, hy gaat ons oor naar Russel toe. Sê, oké. Als hij daar gekomen, dan is hij al klaar daar zo.
Dan wacht ze al klaar?
Dan wacht ze al klaar daar, ja.
Die matrone is daar. Dolfie, let's get back to you. So, it was high school, he played there, and then, how was he? I mean, I'm assuming did he play first team all the way through?
Yeah, he played, I think he started playing directly in the first team for the school because he was quite bigger than all of us, you know. But after school, or while we were playing in school, we were also playing club rugby. So we played
while you were at school.
Yeah, while we were at school.
And which club was that for?
That was for Albions.
Yeah. Albions.
It's a local club down.
Yes, no, we know Albions. Yeah,
local club.
They take you 80 points in the north at the moment.
Yeah, no, they're not that good anymore. I don't
Albions,
know
Albions and Windmill United are kind of they're trying to fight it out to see who's the top of the bottom spot.
Yeah, I know. I just need to tell you, you know, we got 3 Springboks.
3 Springboks for Albions. Mm. You see, Jerome, I've got to just bring this back because it just goes to show incredibly how we still have so many stories to tell. Because there's a club that's not doing great results, but they've put 3 Springboks on the map. It means that Albions themselves have got a story to tell and a story that they can be proud of. And I mean, just that story alone might land them a sponsorship.
Yeah, definitely, JP, and also for the guys at Albions, is the youngsters especially, what Tinas has done there and things like that. I hope that people can go back, all the older guys can go back, and the youngsters can definitely go back and try at least to do something
at
to
Albions.
Remember Tinas, yeah, at Albions, because he gave everything to that club.
So, but I mean, if we look at that as a situation, Albions, and you say Tinas played for Albions.
Yes, and we've got Chester, and we've got Avril. Avril Williams.
This is a story that we need to tell. I mean, imagine if we did another show here, we had someone from Albions and their three Springboks. You know, because this show is a lot about creating awareness for club rugby. I mean, I've got to ask you then, in the last years with Tinas's diagnosis, has Albions been getting much attention? Or has it been all around Tinas?
I don't think the club itself, but I mean, we try to do whatever we can for the club.
Yeah.
But I'm not a lot in the country, so it's quite difficult for me.
Yeah, that's also heavy.
Nee, eintlik nie.
Ja, ek meen as hulle nou die koerant skryf en so, het die mense gesê, jy weet, tennis nou nie, kom van Albion's af, jy weet. So, Chester en tennis en Avril, allemaal by Albion's gespeel. And folks, I mean, I think that's an incredible story because we talk about Albion so much, but we just give it in the results. We never talk about the history and legacy there of a club like Albion's. And I think, you know, I think now we have even more reason to talk about Albion's, considering we want to keep tennis's legacy alive. And this is going to I think that's the next show. Avril, Chester in tennis. Okay, ongelukkig gaan Tinus nou nie saam met ons kan wees op baie show nie, maar ek seker dat hy so nou hier so in die gees hier wees, ja. So you guys played for Albion's and you played for the high school team at the same time.
You know, we will play on a Saturday morning for the school, run off and go play for your club in the afternoon. So we used to play two games in one day, and we got used to it. And after Albion's, Tinus moved on play for Power League. Yeah. Which is out of the clubs, they usually pick sides that will play in the competition of Western Province, which was good those days, but it was tough, you know. Lots of the boys wanted to play for their clubs and not for the Power League, as we call it. But we had fun memories.
It's nog steeds like so. It's still like that.
Yeah. Club was belangrijkste.
Club kom eerste.
Yeah. So that's how they.
God, King and Country.
But we've got
but in club rugby is for club God, King and Country. Yeah. So Russel, did you also then play that? Was that, at that stage that you started playing league?
Ik het voor Riverstones gespeeld.
Riverstones.
Ja.
United Riverstones.
Nee, Riverstones die club zelf. Ja.
Is dat nou niet Riverstones United niet?
Ja, dat is nou nog een club van Riverstones United.
Nog een
ene? Ja.
Ze hadden kopie net jouw naam.
Ja.
Zeker met jij daar was.
En dan dat ik Perelliga gespeeld had, van Perelliga werd ik VP Liga en dan VP gespeeld.
Jerome, nou waar pas jij in die picture en waar had jij nou eerst de Fatines ontmoet?
Ik ken ook al Fatines nou van school daar af al. En ek, van school daar af het mensen al gepraat van Fatines en ons het altijd ook op school, het ons altijd gaan speel in Perel en goed, dus allemaal altijd, maar je moet maar versigtig wees as Tinus daar in die ronde is. So, van school af het ons al geweet al van Tinus al. So ek ken hom vir hom van school af en en toe 1990 toe Tinus en Chester saam in die WP span gekom en toe af het ons saam WP gespeel en verskeie SA spanne saam gespeel en ek ken ook al Tinus.
Nou, how difficult was it for two colored guys to play in a white team?
I would say JP, it was back then it was easier for a backline player to make it into a provincial team or national team. It was tough for me as a forward. Because you're always like one of the smallest guys on the field as a forward with that big Afrikaner white guys.
Really?
And but I mean Tinus and Chester, I mean they were still young. They were about 20, 21, 20. Yeah, I think they were still 20 when they played for Western Province in the Western Curry Cup side.
Yeah.
And I mean they've never got dropped. They've played from that time. They were just every week playing. Cool. So only through injuries they were out of the team.
Russel, jy was mos klaar in die picture op daai stadium.
Yeah.
Ek meen hoe ons praat baie keer baie van hierdie jy weet hoe moeilik het was om rugby te inbreek in die unification spasie in of so. Wat is jou opinie? Hoe moeilik of maklik was het vir Tinus en Chester?
Okay, hulle die tyd toe ek gespeel het was het bietjie moeilik vir my.
Ja. Want jy was voor hulle in die picture.
Voor, ja. Ek het Wolford, tot Wolford gekom.
Kupido?
Yes, ja.
Ja.
En toe oors nog uit is, toe kom Chester en Tinus. En wat ek wil sê is, altijd as Tinus vir my gebel het en gesê het, hy kom na my toe. Het ons een paar drankjes gemaakt, daar by my gebraai.
Ja.
En dan begin die singerie. En sy geef ginseling, nommerkie was altijd gewees, de Green Green Grass of Hope.
Oh, was hy sy song?
Hy was sy song gewees. As ons so getrek geraak het.
Ja.
En begin ons te loop. En daarna begin die tranen te loop.
Ag nee jong, dit klink al sad jong. Ons het 'n paar foto's hierso mense. Ons het 'n paar foto's hierso van die begrafnis en ek dink I think you guys will know some of these legends. Let's quickly take a look at the Abraham. Abraham sent this in. This is, of course, from Tennis's funeral there. Who's like that right in the front there in the white shirt? Is that Charlton?
Charlton.
Yeah. Charlton up there. Yeah. And then,
it's Mark Willard, eh?
Where's Mark? I can't see Mark there. Anyway, there's quite a couple of legends in this photograph there. Of course, at the funeral. Let's take a look at the next picture there. Guys, you can give us the names here from left to right.
Andre Moses and Clark Roberts.
Clark Roberts.
This is Jeffrey Stevens, the other one on the side.
Jeffrey Stevens.
And that's, of course, Abraham Fredericks there with the black jersey on in his Northern's Rugby Football Club. You have Clark Roberts there, of course, also played for the Legends. In fact, all three of those on the two on the left, Abraham, I think, was watching at the Northern's game. All three played in the Legends day at Northern's Avonwood on the day. Let's look at the next picture here that Abraham kindly sent in. Of course, there's big Tino Hector at the back there, and Abraham on the left-hand side, and Faisal Felton on the far right. Yeah. Looks like he's just come back from Mumbai. And who's the gentleman in the next to Tino there, Jerome? I'm saying rechter kan.
I can't.
Anyway, a little bit tricky to see, but that does look to me like a young Gardens or maybe a lower pole.
It's also a guy from Northern's Avenue. Northern, Gerald Scholes in front.
It's a Gerald Scholes forward, man. Yeah. What a jersey is Dino? That
like Northern's.
The blow jersey.
Yeah. Yeah.
So is it the old badge?
Yeah.
Then must the badge for
another. Yeah.
All right. Old. Okay. All right then, folks. That's some interesting photographs. So tell us a little bit about the funeral itself, Jerome.
Yeah. I must say the funeral was everybody that spoke the pastor was very good. He was great. His message was great. Then Fakile, the minister of sport, was very good. And one thing that he said is that they're gonna start with they're in the process with and they've got money to open an academy which is gonna be called the Tennis Lanier Rugby Academy in Paarl. So that was a good thing, and he said that it's not just talking; they're definitely gonna do that. And then also the Springboks overseas, Heineken and Zander Villiers, because Zander Villiers. The first game that he played for
Tennis on his
played
outside.
With Tennis, so he sent a message and lots of messages from.
He could have had. It would have done him well to have Tennis in the back line with him this weekend, though.
I think so, yeah. It would have done him well. Okay. And and Francois Pina was there, and Kubas Visser, and Chris Russel, the Springbok hooker, were there.
Gary Bosov? He's in the paddle streak.
There were so many people, you couldn't tell.
What was the mood?
It was.
Because, I mean, I know what rugby guys are like. They still get together and they tell old stories, wedding, funerals.
Yeah, it was like that, and it was good to see all the old faces and things. You normally get to see these people at funerals and things. So it was good to see them, and also the stories that people were telling about Tennis. Everybody's got a different story, because there's lots of stories about Tennis. I mean, guy always have a smile, always, and as Russel says, he's always used to sing and everything. But the funeral, everything, I think the whole thing, and the municipality, or the police and everybody was quite good. The traffic was smooth. Everything was like, it was almost like everybody was talking about a state funeral, but he had his own state funeral in Paarl. I mean, it was really, really amazing, and it was really good. And I mean, just the legacy that he left, and I mean, he never lived. You would never say that a guy can get that. He never, Tennis was the most humble person.
He was a quiet guy. Yeah, I mean, he wasn't a big, outspoken. He certainly, one thing I never picked up about Tennis was a political edge.
Yeah, nothing like that. He just went on with his life and talking. And
look, I've got to interrupt you there. Unfortunately, we have to pay the bills. We're going to take an ad break. When we come back, we'll wrap it up. We're back with you in a sec. Welcome back, folks. Yes, so of course, let's quickly wrap up the Sevens rugby. We managed to speak to Ruan Mostert early on. Let's catch up now with UWC captain Dale van Schalkwyk. And he talks about the two tournaments during the weekend as well as their preparation for the USA tournament. Dale van Schalkwyk, captain of UWC.
I guess the saying that says winning is contagious is very true. Two out of two within 5 days is very, very much something to be happy about. Very thankful to everybody that has been contributing, Western Province Club Rugby, for organizing a tournament like this as well. And City Park playing good host to us week in and week out. It's great to have yet another win. The boys have been working hard, like I've said on Saturday, and we just very happy to be here, you know, and very happy to be getting medals. At the end of the day, it's two tournaments, two wins, but the big one is USA, and we're working forward to that. Coming through here in the end, you could see some BMT coming in from Saturday where the boys are experienced in the final already, and it's really showing, and hopefully we build on that coming into USA. Life's easy, like I told you on Saturday, the boys are coming through, Freddie Miller, and now we're picking up names like Jacqueline Moses, Flippy. The boys are definitely coming through quick and fast, and we can only build on it. I just want to send a shout out to all the UWC Bushes. Stay behind us, my girlfriend will be here, and thank you to each and every person.
Good old Dale there, always got a smile, and there's a young guy that's come through the ranks. Jerome, I'm going to go to it, also by UW to us. Toe ek vir jou gehelp het. Yeah. Hy was nogal 'n ouetjie met talent, né?
Ja, hy was altyd, jong mannetjie wat goed deurkom en hy het leadership ability, so ek is bly om te sien.
Ja, dis great om te sien. It must make you happy, like kind of for my emotional sense. You do it a lot, seeing the little kids come through and then one day they play for Province or Springboks.
Yeah, definitely. And as I said, with his leadership abilities and things like that, it's good to see. We've seen him.
Yeah.
He was a bit smaller. He's getting bigger now. He's getting mature. So it's good. It's good to see.
Of course, the coach of UWC, Clement Trout, a very happy man on the day. Let's see what Clement had to say.
Very, very, very happy for the boys. I sound very happy. After the weekend at Rockets, Monday, we asked the boys how they're feeling. We decided to have a nice session just to drain the boys, but we had the fitness session, you know, because we knew it was going to be difficult tonight. And the boys pushed through. We pushed them very hard, actually. Gave them a day off, and we came and had a captain's run after that. So, yeah, it was all about the commitment at the end of the boys. Nah, it was a bit short because Kelsen was a very good outfit. And I think they had a tough semi-final. So did we. But they were dangerous players, so we were a bit. And they have a different type of game plan. But the guy, the vibe in the camp is unbelievable. At the moment, you say we're not the biggest of boys, but very skillful, very fast, but I think that's more about teamwork. Now, as I mentioned to you last week, we don't want any titles, we just do our thing, we stay humble. We're working hard at the end of the day, and it's dedicated to our late coach, and at the end of the day, we're ambassadors for the university. There's what players, if players buy into what we want, that's the first point of entry. Guys believe in the coaches, players believe in the guys, we're on the same path, so they buy into the concept and we go forward.
Right, folks, Cape Rugby TV, and of course, if you've been watching, you'll know that tonight's show was dedicated to the life and times of Tennyson Nee, and the best way that we felt we could remember his legacy, and I'm sure his legacy is going to be in your minds still for many, many years to come, that you'll never forget him, especially his friends. But we thought that the best way to celebrate his life and times was to do it through the eyes and ears and memories of his friends. And of course, Russel, Roux, close friend, played with tennis. Russel, I must say to you, thank you very much for joining us on the show. I'm sure that if we had to go and have a couple of cold ones somewhere, that I'll have many more stories.
Of course, yes.
So thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
There we go. And Dolfie, Veer, lekker om met jou te gesels ook vanavond. Lekker om al die stories te hoor van tennis. En soos ons gesê het, voordat jy weet, is die tyd net so verby en ons het nie die helfte van die stories vertel.
Baie dankie, JP, en gaan voort met die goeie werk wat jy doen.
Dankie, and then Jerome, we'll see you back on the show in the next couple of days. And of course you can keep telling us about tennis because we keep seeing you on the show, and it's always such a privilege to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, JP, just one thing is that we're going on Thursday. We're invited to the premiere. She's also have a tribute to tennis. So I don't know when Tinas is going to let us go because it just goes on, but we still have that. So it's still this week. We're still busy with it. hopefully by next week they we'll stop with it. But that's no, just the well legacy that the men left.
Exactly.
It's amazing.
I can tell you that as long as the show exists, tennis will never let you go.
No, we never.
Right, folks, there you go. That's a wrap of Cape Rugby TV. We do it on a slightly sad, nostalgic, but also in a spirit of good memory note. Enjoy your rugby weekend. Best of luck to the Springboks this weekend. I mean that in the very best sense of the word. I'm sure that they'll make a strong comeback. They've got enough talent that they've taken on tour with them. So I'm sure Hanneke Meyer can certainly tap into the depth of the squad that he's taken on tour with him. We'll see you again next week, same time, same place. Bye-bye.